Good evening, everyone. I'm going to talk about when the axes don't meet, which one do you treat. Different ablation profiles are present, while my talk will be about topography-guided ablation. The topography-guided ablation, or Contura, uses data from refraction and the corneal topography to create a smooth regular cornea depending on high-quality topolizer images. It was FDA approved in 2013. And the FDA study, which was a prospective non-randomized study performed in 9 centers, and they found that there is an excellent refractive predictability and uncorrected visual acuity after Contura. And the cylinder they treated was the manifest refraction in both amount and axis. But in scenario like this, if a patient had a refraction of -3, -2 at axis 110, and the topolizer found that his he has a cylinder of -3 at a different axis, which amount and which axis are you going to treat? And this was our research question. To try to reply on this question, there are some theoretical background we will go through that in eyes with higher order aberration, we don't include them separately in the manifest refraction. The aberration sum up to an astigmatic equivalent, and this astigmatic equivalent has its amount and axis, which is different from the true lower order primary astigmatism. So the manifest astigmatism is the sum of the true lower lower order primary astigmatism and this astigmatic equivalent. So if you're using the standard ablation, you correct the manifest astigmatism. However, when you're using the Contura or the topography guided ablation, you treat this astigmatic equivalent by default because it starts the ablation with the regularization of the cornea. This regularization of the cornea removed some micro irregularities of the cornea, which are responsible for this astigmatic equivalent. So if we're going to treat the manifest refraction, so you will end up with induced new astigmatism. But when you are treating the lower order astigmatism, you will reach an optimum correction. And this is the science behind the LIRA protocol, which was proposed by Professor Metwine. And then after that topography modified refraction technique were introduced, in which the astigmatism amount and axis from the topolizer were taken, and the sphere will be modulated so that to keep the same spherical equivalent as the manifest refraction, some sort of tuning down the LIRA protocol. But in my opinion, it does not make a perfect sense because you either trust your technology and trust your machine or not. So in our study, we included 60 eyes. So if we have a patient with manifest refraction -2 and -2 at axis 160, and the topolizer found that he has an astigmatism of 3 diopters at an axis 140, we have 3 groups. The first group, we treat the manifest refraction as it is. And in the second group, we treated adopted the TMR technique. We modified the sphere and used the topolizer astigmatism amount and axis. And in the third group, which is called the partial TMR group, we took the manifest sphere as it is and the astigmatism amount and axis by the topolizer. Our patients were all astigmatic, above 1.5 diopters, and a difference between the topolizer reading and the manifest astigmatism more than 0.5 diopters. And these were the preoperative refractive astigmatism. They were all comparable. And after 3 months, we found that the unaided postoperative visual acuity was highest in the partial TMR group, and the residual refractive astigmatism were comparable to each other. However, they were the least at the third group, and the residual refractive astigmatism was the lowest in the third group, and they were statistically significant. As you notice here, the third group had the highest unaided visual acuity. About 75% of these patients had uncorrected vision of better than 6/6, and about 65% of these patients gained more than 2 lines. And the residual anterior corneal astigmatism was the lowest in this group. However, no statistically significant difference was found in the different between the no statistically significant in the manifest astigmatism. So the safety and the efficacy was studied in the FDA study. It was safe and effective, and they found that 94% of the eyes were within 0.5 diopters of the targeted astigmatism, and in our study, statistically significant difference was found in the unaided post-operative visual acuity between the three groups. And it was published in the Clinical Ophthalmology. The whole study was under supervision of Dr. Mohammed Hosni, and I was honored to have Dr. Mohammed Shafiq discussing my MD thesis. So in conclusion, the post-operative unaided visual acuity after topography-guided ablation, regardless, the strategy was found to be better than the pre-operative corrected visual acuity. And the post-operative unaided vision was found to be statistically significant, higher than when we are using the topographic astigmatism in treatment. And if you're not sure of the topography images, so you can use another type of treatment, whether wavefront optimized or wavefront guided. But if you are trusting your machine, the images are reliable and reproducible, so use the topographic astigmatism better than the manifest astigmatism. And thank you for your attention.